Hi, good day. Today we will study about the variables. So a variable is a quantity that may change within the context of a mathematical problem or experiment. Typically, we use a single letter to represent a variable. The letters X, Y, and Z are common generic symbols used for variables. So variables is that for you to imagine that it has one or more value, but you don't know what they are, or you want whatever you say about it to be equally true for all elements in a given set, and so you don't want to be restricted to considering only a particular concrete value for it. So, variables, example, is the number with the following property, doubling it and adding 3 gives the same result as squaring it. Is there a number x with the property that 2x plus 3 is equals to x? So here in this sentence, we introduce a variable to replace the potentially ambiguous word it. So in this sentence, we can see that there is an it word and we replace it with x here in the next example. So next is there a number replace it with the box now, so with the property that 2 times box plus 3 is equals to 2 box squared. So, to illustrate the second use of variables, consider the statement, no matter what the number might be chosen, if it's greater than 2, then its square is greater than 4. In this case, introducing a variable to give a temporary name to the arbitrary number you might choose enables you to maintain the generality of the statement and replacing all the instances of the word it by the name of the variable ensures that possible ambiguity is avoided. So, writing sentences using variables, are there number with the property that the sum of their squares equals the square of their sum? So, are there a number A and B with the property of A squared and B squared is equals to A plus B squared? Or, are there numbers A and B such that A squared plus B squared is equals to A plus B squared? Or do there exist any numbers A and B such that A squared plus B squared is equals to A plus B squared? So the next example, given any real number, its square is non-negative. Given any real number, R is the variable of real number, R squared is non-negative. Or for any real number, R squared is greater than or equal 0. Or for all real numbers, R squared is greater than or equal 0. So next is the universal statement. A universal statement says a certain property is true for all elements is a set. So, for example, all positive numbers are greater than 0. For us to determine if it's a universal statement, we should see the clue word here, all positive numbers are greater than 0. So, it's true. The property is true for all elements is a set. Next, conditional statement. A conditional statement says that if one thing is true, then some other thing has also to be true. For example, if 378 is divisible by 18, then 378 is divisible by 6. So, for us to identify the conditional statement, we should look for the if word and then begun word if and then. Next is the existential statement. An existential statement says that there is at least one thing for which the property is true. For example, there is a prime number that is even, so it is true that there is a prime number that is even. So, for us to identify the existential statement, we should look at the word there is. So, next is the universal conditional statement. The universal conditional statement is a statement that is both universal and conditional. So, we must see here that for all, for every, or everything that comes with universal and if and then conditional statement. For example, for all animals, A is the variable of animals. If A is a dog, then A is a mammal. So, we can see here that for all, which states that it is a universal statement, and then if, and then as a conditional statement. Next, for all animals, A, as I said earlier, A is the variable of animals. If A is a dog, then A is a mammal. So, we can see, so for us to determine the conditional, this is what I'm talking about. If, so we can say the if here and then the then word here. If a animal is a dog, then the animal is a mammal. So for universal statement, for all, the word all is, determines that it is a universal statement. For all dogs, A is a mammal. Or all dogs are mammal. So next is the universal existential statement. So, a universal existential statement is a statement that is universal because its first part says that a certain property is true for all objects of a given type, and it is existential because its second part asserts the existence of something. So, this is to give an example. Every real number has an additive inverse. In this statement, the property has an additive inverse implies universally to all real numbers. Has an additive inverse asserts the existence of something, an additive inverse, for each real number. However, the nature of the additive inverse depends on the real number. Different real numbers have different additive inverses. Knowing that that an additive inverse is a real number, you can rewrite this statement in several ways, some less formal or some more formal. For example, all real numbers have an additive inverse, or for all real numbers, there is an additive inverse for R. So, we can see here that there is a word all for all, and there is a word there is. For all determines that it is a universal statement, and there is determines that this is an existential statement. Or we can write it like for all real numbers R, there is a real number S such that S is an additive inverse for. So introducing list of for the variable simplifies reference in further discussion. For instances, after the third version of the statement, you might go on to write when R is positive, S is negative, when R is negative, S is positive, and when R is 0, S is also 0. So next is the existential universal statement. An existential universal statement is a statement that is existential because its first part asserts that a certain object exists and is universal because its second part says that the object satisfies a certain property for all things. So, for example, there is a positive integer that is less than or equal to every positive integer. This statement is true because the number 1 is a positive integer and it satisfies the property of being less than or equal to every positive integer. We can write the statement in several ways, some less formal and some more formal. There is a positive integer m that is less than or equal to every positive integer. So as I said earlier, a variable can be replaceable by any alphabets. So next is there is a positive integer m such that every positive integer is greater than or equal to m. So we can see here that there is word which is existential, and then the every word that can be a universal statement. So next example here is there is a positive integer m with the property that for all positive integers n, m less than or equal n. Thanks for watching.